I know, you want a free ad blocker, but there's a problem. You can't entrust the tasks of dealing with ads, trackers, and malicious links to an app that might not even work. That's why, yeah, I'd love to give you the best free ad block the internet can offer, an easy way to block all ads completely, but I just can't. I can't do that. Hear me out. Free ad blocker options can help out a little, but as time goes on, they show themselves to be less and less reliable. The majority of free ad blockers have limited compatibility, no customer support, and generally tend to become ineffective against the newer types of ads and pop-ups. They're also free only in terms of money. Nothing stops a free ad blocker from earning money by selling your browsing patterns or maybe even your data in general. That's why I'd rather stick to a trustworthy app. I'm going to introduce you to how you can get paid ad blockers for free, which is going to be way more useful for users prioritizing their privacy and security. Right, the best freemium ad blocker I can recommend is none other than Total Adblock. You don't need to download any apps. Total Adblock does its entire job through a browser extension, but you can also block ads on Android and iPhone. So what's the difference between the free and premium versions? First, the premium plan offers more customization, but the most important difference is that the free version doesn't block all the ads, only the ones from top websites. Using Total Adblock is incredibly easy. It has two primary options, blocking ads and blocking pop-ups. Of course, we want to enable both of those. Now, premium users get more options like adding websites to the exceptions list. I wanted to see how this ad blocker works in real life scenarios, and my setup was simple. First, I browsed weather.com and newyorktimes.com websites without Total Adblock. Then I turned the extension on. Normally, there are tons of pop-ups, notifications, and ads. With Total Adblock, I can see none of that. Even going to a special website designed specifically to test the prowess of your ad blocker, Total Adblock managed to clean all of it. I also like the more detailed report showing how many ads and trackers it blocks on every page, but it also highlights how much data it saved since fewer ads means better loading time. And to be fair, the difference is pretty noticeable on a day-to-day basis. So I highly recommend going with the premium Total Adblock to block all ads everywhere. It's the cheapest premium option on my list, and it doesn't just improve your ad blocking experience. You also get PC or Mac tune-up tools and a YouTube ad blocker. So I recommend grabbing this deal if you want to have a clean browsing experience, and I'll leave my discount link down below. Make sure you check that out before you buy. Now, my second recommendation is the Threat Protection ad block from NordVPN. In my experience, this is one of the best ad blockers I've had a chance to try out so far. Despite being a paid service, Threat Protection offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can effectively use it for free for over a month. In terms of effectiveness, Threat Protection blocks ads, trackers, pop-ups, notifications, but that's what all ad blockers do, right? So Threat Protection won me over because it can also weed out malicious websites and even block malware downloads. Just as an example, look how easy it is for Threat Protection to tackle ad-filled websites like this one. Normally, there are tons of pop-ups, notifications, and ads, but with Threat Protection, I can see none of that. Even the website designed to test ad blockers recognizes Threat Protection's powers. Previously, Threat Protection was available only as part of the NordVPN subscription. You could still get NordVPN with Threat Protection, with a discount too, I might add. Just click the link at the top right of the screen. But you don't have to. Threat Protection is flexible in terms of device connections. It can be used on up to 6 devices at the same time. So it's available right now on macOS and Windows, but the mobile devices have a light version, which requires a VPN connection to work, and it can't deal with malware. The same goes if you want to use an extension to block ads. So the Chrome extension, alongside other browser extensions, uses the light version as well. So if you do need an ad blocker on your mobile phone, consider getting the Threat Protection plan that includes a VPN as well as multiple other nice benefits. I mean, it's gonna be worth it, especially if you keep in mind that that discount you can use to cut your price considerably. One more ad block I wanna discuss is also connected to a popular VPN. I'm talking about Surfshark's CleanWeb. Using CleanWeb, I could see how effective it is against ads, pop-ups, trackers, and malicious websites. The only thing that's missing in this app is malware protection. That's the first major distinction from Nord's threat protection. Yeah, I said in the app. That's because CleanWeb has a different way to block ads. The browser extension uses CleanWeb 2.0, which doesn't only block ads and pop-ups, it also includes data breach alert and malware alert. The former notifies you of any data leaks, while the latter detects malware in downloads and on websites, just like threat protection. This makes CleanWeb the best ad blocker for Chrome and other browsers so far. You can take a look at CleanWeb's effectiveness yourself. I'm gonna run it against the same tests as threat protection. Sadly, it's not gonna be as entertaining as the first time because CleanWeb doesn't have any issues with blocking these online nuisances whatsoever. Compared to threat protection, CleanWeb has one more significant difference. It can't be acquired separately from Surfshark, but Surfshark is significantly cheaper than NordVPN, so I don't think it's a big downside. So similar to threat protection, Surfshark's CleanWeb comes with a 7-day free trial and a 30-day money-back guarantee, but Surfshark has no limits on how many people can use the subscription at the same time, which is way better than NordVPN's mere 6 devices limit. To summarize, nowadays, good ad blockers can block malware, monitor your leaks, filter out malicious websites, and so much more. It's just much harder for free ad blockers to keep up. They just can't do it. So if you really value your online experience, consider investing a little bit in a premium ad blocker solution. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope you'll consider leaving a like, maybe a comment, subscribe if you will, and I'll see you soon in the next one.